name is Jerwina Arneo. I'm currently an instructor at the University of San Carlos. So we have here the first one. So it's an application of the fundamental operation. So you have here your addition and your subtraction. So you can do first addition, or you can do either from left to right. So you can do this one and then followed by this one. I know you are not allowed to use calculator. You have to be quick in solving for that. The tip is for addition. So you can say, for example, use 5 and 8 or the last digits of the addends here. So this is in the 10,000s and this one is only in the 1,000s. So of course you have to align it when you add it. So notice that 5 plus 8 first, the last two digits you have here for this one, you have 8 and 6, you have 5 and 4. So I want you to operate on that first. So you have 8 and 5. So that means you have 13. And you have your 6 and 4 plus 1. So you have your 11. Next is also this one. You can do, look at there in the thousands. So you can look at the last two digits here, the ones and the tens places. So you can operate that one so that you can eliminate your choices C and D. So in that manner, so if you try to solve the last two digits only, you'd see that you can get a number equal to 7. So since the last digit here is 7, that is in A, choices A and B. So you have eliminated C and D already. So you have to choose A and between A and B. And that's the time that you can do the full subtraction of this one, just to save time. So the answer for this one would be letter A, 13,637. Number two, so it's an example of a complex fraction. So you have here, you're given as x plus 2x over x minus 2 all over 1 plus 4 over x squared minus 4. So rule says you need to express the numerator in its similar fraction as well as the denominator, and then simplify both numerator and denominator. First, we'll be needing here our LCD, where you have here, you are given x plus 2x over x minus 2 all over 1 plus 4 over x squared minus 4. X squared minus 4. If you have noticed, x squared minus 4 is a binomial. Okay, you can simplify this one or get the factors of your x squared minus 4. So your factors here would be x plus 2 and x minus 2, correct? So first, we need to get the LCD of our numerator. So that would be x minus 2. So since this one is understood as x over 1. There you divide the LCD to the denominator of each fraction in your numerator. So x minus 2 divided by 1. So that would be x minus 2 times x. We can write that as x times x minus 2 plus, just extend the bar here, x minus 2 divided by x minus 2. That would be 1 times 2x. So we have here plus 2x. Okay, you can also do individual. So you do first the numerator if you don't like the way I presented it, so that you can really follow the flow. You can have it as numerator first and followed by denominator. Next is for your denominator, x squared minus 4. That would be our LCD. So same thing with what you did with the numerator. So x squared minus 4 divided by 1. So that would be x squared minus 4 times 1. X squared minus 4 plus x squared minus 4 divided by x squared minus 4. So that's 1 times 4 will give you 4 over x squared minus 4. Now simplifying further, this one you need to distribute. So that would be x squared minus 2x plus 2x over x minus 2 over. So we have here x squared. So minus 4 plus 4 would be 0. And cancel that out for x minus 4. Next is to do the division. So that means we need to flip our divisor. So x squared minus 2x plus 2. Rather, this is already canceled out. X squared over x minus 2. So if we are going to get the reciprocal, you also change the operation to multiplication. So this one would be x squared minus 4 over x squared, right? So since it appears both in the denominator and numerator, can cancel that out. So that means you have x squared minus 4 over x minus minus 2. As what I have said, we can factor, can get the factors of your x squared minus 4. That would be x plus 2 times x minus 2. Lower x minus 2. So we can cancel out x minus 2. So the final answer would be the x plus 2. That would be letter D from the choices. Another tip is you can eliminate A and B here. We can, without solving it, we can inspect it by inspection that our final answer should be in a this form of polynomial of your binomial. Because you are sure that x minus 2 is a factor of your x squared minus 4. So that leaves us with C and D as our choices. Okay, to save time. Next, let's have number 3. Number 3 would involve the laws of exponents here. So we have to simplify this one, right? So let's do this. So number 3, we have here 25 raised to the power of negative 1 plus 25 raised to the power of negative 2 all over. We have here 625 raised to the power of 0 plus 25 raised to the power of negative 2. So you can observe it mostly involves of a negative exponent. So what we do with the negative exponent, we have to change it to a positive 1. Now, we also have here the application of your 0 exponent. Okay? So that means this will be simplified to 1. So applying the negative exponent, so 25 raised to the power of 1 would be 1 over 25 plus 1 over 25 squared all over 1 plus 1 over 25 squared. So this time now, we can further simplify this one. So by using the LCD, so 25 squared will give us 625. So that means our LCD here is, for the numerator, is 625. So again, 625 divided by 25, that's 25 times 1. So you have here 25 plus 625 divided by 625 times 1 will give us 1 over. Now, our LCD for the denominator is also 625. So the same process, 625 divided by 1 times 1 will give us 625 plus this one divided by itself times 1 give us 1. So just simplify, you have 26 over 625. All over 626 over 625. Since this is now division, we can get the reciprocal of our divisor. So that would be 26 over 625. And change division to multiplication. It would be 625 over 626. Cancel 625. So we now have 26 over 626. Since the last digits here are both 6, that means they are divisible with one another. So we just need to find a common factor that we can simplify or reduce our fraction into lowest term. So find a factor that you can divide both 26 and 626. So in that manner, it would be 2. The 6 is divisible by 2. Use that. Would be 13 over 313. This would be the answer for that number, which is not in the choices. So in the event that the answer is not found in the choices and you're very sure that you answered it correctly, when I had my review before in engineering, so the based also from the experience, you just choose the closest one in the choices. So the closest, I think, would be letter B. When in doubt, choose the closest one, right? The answer not in the choices. Next, number 4 is a multiplication of your radical. So just use the rule there in the multiplication of your radical. So we have here 4 square root of 3 times 5 square root of 3. So combine the coefficients, 4 times 5, and then also the one with the radical sign. So that means this one is 20. For this one, apply product rule. So this is the square root of 3 and multiply it by the square root of 3. Square root means raised to the power of 1/2. So they have the same base. you have to add the exponent. So 1/2 plus 1/2, that's just 1. 3 raised to the power of 1 will give you 3. 20 times 3, which is equal to 16. That would be letter C from the choices. For number 5, if you have observed for number 5, they have the same base, just 3, but already have the exponents are already expressed in its simplest form. So for number 5, the given is actually already expressed in its simplest form. So no, that is already the answer. So from the choices, there is no answer from the choices actually. So you just choose either A or B for that. Okay, number 5, that's already, I don't know what's the question, what's the exam, what's the objective of number 5, but it's already expressed in its simplest form. Okay, now number 6, right? So for number 6, this is the application of your binomial. So let us simplify this one. So you have the addition of 2 binomials. Okay, so we have here, the given is x plus y raised to the power of 3 plus x minus y raised to the power of 3. So we can do this one first. We can expand x plus y, and then later on we'll also expand x minus y. So if we do that, this would be, just follow the pattern that I gave a while ago. So x cubed plus 3x squared y plus 3xy squared plus y cubed. That is for the first binomial. Plus the second one. So the same process. This time, you just have here the subtraction. So x cubed minus 3x squared y plus, so negative times a negative would be positive, plus 3x y squared minus y cubed. Next is to combine like terms and then see if we can further simplify it. So this one, you have a positive y cubed, also have negative y cubed, so we can cancel this out. Then this one also, we have positive and we have a negative. So that means if we are going to combine x cubed plus x cubed, you have 2x cubed plus 3x squared, 3xy squared plus 3xy squared would give us 6xy squared. That is your answer, but take note, it is not found in the choices. That means we have to further simplify our answer by doing or by factoring it out. So you have 2x, so take it out from your parentheses. Then you have x squared plus 3y squared. Your final answer would be expressed in this manner. So 2x times x squared plus 3y squared. Just the same with that, the one that you answered. That is letter A from the choices. Number 7. Alright, so number 7 is the application of your fractions. This time, we need to have the LCD of our fractions here. So we have here 1 plus 6 over x plus 9 over x squared. So we need to get the LCD of our fraction. So the LCD here would be x squared, right? So x squared divided by 1 times 1, so that would be x squared. X squared divided by x, so you just cancel out 1x, so you still have x, remainder x, times 6, so that would be plus 6x. X squared divided by x squared times 9, but your x squared plus 6x plus 3 can be in this manner, can compress it over x squared. Final answer would be x plus 3 squared over x squared, and that would be letter D from the choices. Number 8 is just simply simplifying your polynomials. So by using the distributive property, then combining like terms, okay, by adding or subtracting it. So let's have to number 8. So you have 2 times x minus y plus 3 plus x plus 3y minus 2 times x plus 1. So your goal here is to be conscious of the signs of your variables here, right? Or of your terms here. So let's do the distributive, or let's distribute first to eradicate all the parentheses here, or the groupings. So we have here 2x minus 2y plus 3 plus, you have x plus 3y minus 2 times, negative 2 times x, that would be negative 2x, times, plus negative 2 times 1, so that would be negative 2. Next is to combine like terms, see if you can cancel those with opposite signs, and then the same base or variable. So you have here for 2x, so that means you now have, if you combine negative 2y plus 3y, it will give you y, so 1y plus x, and then the constants, 3 minus 2, it would be plus 1. The final answer, the simplified form of that expression would be y plus x plus 1. Or that is letter B. So it doesn't matter what is the order of your variable, the x or the y. So it's just the same. The answer would be letter B.